Usually during the week, we like to get our food and go. But sometimes, just to slow things down, I like to plonk something right in the middle of the table. And that is where my seafood crumble is perfect for manic weekdays.
This dish is perfect for freezing. So on those busy weekdays, you have a delicious homemade ready meal that can be on the table in no time.
When I make a fish pie, you get these great bags of seafood mix, and they've usually got, they're chained around, they're not always the same. This one has got undyed smoked haddock, we've got some cod, some salmon, some squid rings, some prawn. So it's just like, I just pick it up, and that's my seafood mix. Woo!
The first job is to add the fish to some warm milk. While it poaches, it flavors the milk. After 3 to 4 minutes, the fish is ready to come out.
The first ever white sauce I ever made was at school. And coming from a Bangladeshi home, white sauce was like, where are the chilies? Where's the coriander? Where are the spices? It was completely alien to me. But once you can nail just one white sauce, the possibilities are endless. Lasagna, macaroni, cheese sauce. I mean, there are so many things you can do with one base. So this is such a good one to learn and just keep in the library of recipes in your head.
Throw into a pan equal amounts of unsalted butter and plain flour. Give it a quick stir before adding in the warm milk, a ladle at a time.
What you don't want to do is be tempted and add all the milk at once. A little at a time, slowly, gradually thickening it. That's really important.
When it's a smooth, creamy consistency, you can add in the flavour. I like powdered mustard, a good pinch of salt, and for a mild, oniony hit, I love chopped chives. And then my secret weapon, hard-boiled eggs.
And this is just one of those things that I've always done. I like mixing them through the fish pie because once you've chopped them up, you kind of expose that yolk. And as it mixes through, it makes it even creamier. So the first time I ever ate a fish pie was when I was at high school, and I thought it was disgusting. Although I liked the mash and it was really lumpy, but I wasn't used to eating mash, so I didn't know what a good mash was. They would top the fish pie with an ice cream scoop. I remember that, it was really weird. And there was these big pimples of mashed potato.
Once all the eggs are in, pour in the cooked seafood, and then add some frozen peas.
Straight in, frozen, no need to defrost. I'm just being really gentle not to kind of break anything up too much. I'm just mixing it around and that's it. That's it. So I've got a pie dish ready, extra large, half for eating now, half for eating later. This is gonna save me next week when I feel like having a fish pie and I have one in the freezer. It's like, no work. Always, always think ahead. Now for the crumble bit.
I'm starting off with 225 grams of unsalted butter and 150 grams of plain flour.
And this does make a really welcome change to a normal fish pie if you don't want the potato on top. Or, you know what, if you don't have potatoes at home.
When the butter and flour are like breadcrumbs, mix in some oats and season.
And then I'm going to add some cayenne, because I have to keep reminding myself this is not an apple crumble, it's a seafood crumble. It's savoury.
And then some crispy fried onions. After a mix, spoon the crumble evenly over the fish.
And there you have it, seafood crumble. So if you're making this in advance, you can just cover it up and freeze it now. But I'm baking mine now at 200 degrees for 25 minutes.
My family love this crumble with garlic bread. And don't forget, there's still some in the freezer for next week.